I want to say that this is a very humbling experience to stand in front of this audience. I'm in awe of the many learned speakers we have here. And for me to stand in front of you, just say or share a few words and thoughts. I'm thankful for that opportunity. As Brother Gibbons has mentioned, when I first heard of this Refreshing Waters seminar, for some reason I felt I want to attend. Didn't know why exactly. I'm not great for getting out and doing this type of thing. I don't travel far from home. I've gone through some very trying times. Right now, I'm trying to find direction for my life. I've been a Christian since I was 12 years old. I've been a Sunday school teacher, deacon, elder, for the biggest part of 30 years. Don't be interruptions for medical purposes. But I've reached another crossroads, and I can't seem to find the direction. Back about 30 years ago, when I was in my early 20s, married, had three young children, and I was teaching Sunday school class at that time. One Sunday, preparing for the lesson, and I was studying in Philippians 4. And as I was reading the 11th verse, in which Paul says, "Not that I speak because of want, for I have learned in whatsoever condition or state I find myself, I will be content." And I thought, at that time, I was just a young individual, married, young struggling farmer, with young children, but I was just trying to, you know, get my life in perspective. You know, other young people or young couples were doing this, doing that, and, you know, we couldn't afford to do that, we didn't have the time. I thought, what a great thought, I can just apply this to my own life. Little did I know at that time the circumstances that would come about and just how important that scripture would be to my life, and that is to be content no matter what state I'm in. Some of you may think I talk a little funny. And one lady down on the phone, but I had a sexy voice. But I had chest cancer when I was 36 years old. A thymus tumor. Has anyone ever heard of that before? Saw a hand go up. Well, at the time they found mine, they'd never heard of it before. No one had ever had a thymus tumor. I wasn't even supposed to have a thymus gland when I was 36 years old. It was supposed to disappear when I was about 20 years old. But I still had one. Turned out to be malignant. I remember the surgeon, it took him several days to decide what to do. He said, "Well, we got to talk to the clones." Next day he come in, "Well, we got it off today." I mean, after 3 or 4 days he come back and said, "Well, we decided we think we should do surgery." And then follow up with radiation. And of course, being inquisitive, I said, "Well, you know, what's my options at? You know, what if I don't do it?" He said, "Well, without this, we would give you somewhere 6 months to 18 months to live. We think if you go ahead and do this, that there's a good chance you'll have 10, 15 years. So you'd be 19 years old." Like I say, I've got plenty of voice, but it's far cry better than it was right after the certain. And I am thankful that the Lord has given me this much of a voice. And I made up my mind that what a voice of God I want to share about. And explain what God has done. Well, that went on several years. I changed my profession. I went from farming. I was now a manager or administrator in the town where I now live, South Charleston. 4 years ago, I started having pain in the groin area. I've always been active physically at work and also in sports. I'm an official in basketball, baseball, softball, summer softball, volleyball, you name it. I couldn't turn it down. They'd say, hey, we need an official for this. How about getting your license? Anyway, I started having some pain. I thought I had a pulled muscle. Went to the doctor and he agreed with that, kept giving me pain pills. Got through the basketball season. Baseball season came and he said, you really ought to rest it. I said, well, there's a shortage of baseball umpires. If I can get through the baseball season, I'll rest it then. Well, I got through it. I rested it for a while. Started feeling better. Well, that's the problem. Got a call one weekend. Said, hey, we got a state softball tournament here in town. We really need some umpires. How about helping us out this weekend? I said, yeah, I think I can handle it. And I got through the first day. Second day, I went to make a move. Thought the throw was going to go second and to third. When I made the quick move to get out and cover the play, intense pain went through the hip area. I thought, oh, something wrong. Couldn't get anybody to cover the next game, so I got through it. Went back to the doctor and said, talk something wrong. I went to the hospital. Went to the hospital. Decided I had arthritis. The orthopedic surgeon said, not really sold on it, but I can't find anything else. Sent him home, a month later, got it worse. Well, then went back and again, it's another form of cancer. There's three basic forms of cancer. I realize there's variation of each one. I've had two of them. I haven't had melanoma yet. But I've had the other two, and according to doctors, doing all right. Those doctors just last Friday. I quit taking my last medication. And what I said to him, I said, I've come along pretty good. I said, if anything, the only problem I've got, I feel too good. You know, physically, I'd like to do things. I'd love to be able to go out and officiate sports. I'd love to play. I'm 50-some years old. I'd love to play basketball again. I was still playing. Up to the very time I was taken down. And he said to me, he said, what are you upset about? He said, you realize that 4 years ago, you were that close to death. And yet with God's help, you're doing fine. And I said, yes, I realize that. I said, my physical problems aren't what's bothering me. I said, I've never blamed God for my physical problems. That thought's never entered my head. But I said, it's my mind. I just can't get focused on having some emotional problems. Well, I'm hoping that this few days will help. As I said, the scripture that's carried me for 30 years is Philippians 4:11. But also a couple of years ago, I kind of picked up Philippians 1:21. Very short. I also find that most people don't like to hear all of it. I think this group is strong enough in the knowledge and faith of our Lord Jesus Christ. Maybe you already have accepted the full body. But it says, to live is Christ, to die is gain. Let me say, a couple of years ago, I was over the immediate danger, and I thought, I'm going to live another couple of years, maybe three or four. So I got a little time left. So while God gives me life, I want to give it to Him. But I also admit at that very time, I wish God would call me home. I wanted to go. I still struggle with that. The emotional state I'm at right now. Yes, I have been blessed immensely. I have a wonderful wife, three lovely children, three lovely grandchildren. But I don't know what God wants me to do. And it's a struggle for me in that direction. I pray that something will be said these next few days. Didn't say at the beginning, I attend Great Grove Church of Christ, which is right out here in the middle of it all. There's Jeffersonville, South Charleston, Cedarville, and Jamestown. Four communities, Great Grove, right in the middle. So we're in the heart of it. The minister here is here today, David Finnessy. He's been a great help. We spent a lot of hours for him. And I keep thinking, he ought to get exasperated because we talk and I think he's just got me straightened out, got everything under control. And I go a few days or a week and I go, well, with God's help, I know I'll make it. I just need some help. And I know he is, and I need it from God and Jesus Christ. But I've also found the brothers and sisters in Christ have been so great. And they've been such a big help. And I'm counting on them.